I think the question is very clear to you. Question is from your book NCRT exercise 5.1, question number 19, and what we have to prove f of x is equal to x minus greatest integer x is discontinuous at all integers. So let k be an integer. We are assuming that k is an integer. So you can think k is 5. For example, k can be taken as 5, but you cannot write k is equal to 5 in your response. So at the last, you will have to erase this. So at x is equal to k, what is k? K is any integer. K is any integer, and for convenience, we are assuming that k is 5. But at the last, we shall remove this k is equal to 5. At x is equal to 1, right hand limit as per our formula will be limit h tends to 0 f of a plus h. But here a is what? Here a is k. So right hand limit is limit h tends to 0 f of k plus h. Since we have only one function, and the function is this, f of x is equal to x minus greatest integer x. We do not have any choice for less than or smaller, greater than. So all the values should be substituted in this function only. So limit h tends to 0, f of k plus h, we shall substitute instead of x in the function and let this function be 1. So f of k plus h can be obtained by putting x is equal to k plus h in number 1. So k plus h minus greatest integer k plus h. As I told you, that thing that k is 5. Suppose if k is 5, then greatest integral value of 5 plus h will be what? So greatest integer of 5 plus h is very good. It is 5. Is it 5? Because h is negligible, and h being negligible, it will be like 5 plus 0.0001. And 0.001 is what? It is 5. So greatest integral value of 5 plus h will be 5. Similarly, the greatest integral value of k plus h will be k. Without putting value of h, which is tending towards 0, we are not putting the value. We did not put the value. In spite of this, we obtained its value k. And the value is k, which should not be kept in closed bracket, because the value has been calculated and limit h tends to 0, k plus h. Here we have not substituted value of k, h, so it will remain like this, but it has come without calculating, without putting h is equal to 0. So mind it, it should be very clear to you all that here where this arrow is made and the arrow is directing you that we did not put k, h is equal to 0. In spite of this, value of this greatest integral value of function of k plus h is k. Now as k can be cancelled, and as h tends to 0, the outcome is 0. So its limiting value is 0. Left hand limit is equal to limit h tends to 0 f of a minus h, and a in this case is k, we have assumed. So it will be like this, f of k minus h, f of k minus h. And as I told you that there is only one function which we have assigned, number 1, f of x is equal to x minus greatest integer. So all the values should be kept in that function only. So limit h tends to 0, f of k minus h will be k minus h minus greatest integral function of k minus h, and its greatest integral value we need to calculate. Let's k, let k be 5 as we have assumed. This is an idea, but we need not to write in solution. So if k is 5 and 5 minus h, latest integral value of 5 minus h will be what? 4, because h is negligible, and h is negligible, then it will be like this, 5.0001. So outcome will be 4.999, and the greatest integral function says do write, sorry, 4.009, and the greatest integral, this 4.999, which is smaller than 5, and greatest integral function says that do write the value which is smaller than or equal to and must be an integer. So any value which is smaller than this 4 point and nearest, it should be nearest value. So for any value which is smaller than 4.999, which is very near, which is nearest to this and should be an integer, so it is 4. So how 4 has come? How 4 has come? Suppose if k is 5, then the outcome will be what? K minus
1. Minus 1.
Very nice. Limit h tends to 0, k minus h minus, and the outcome will be k minus 1, and the bracket, closed bracket should not be used now, because the closed bracket is not for the purpose of decoration. So we have to remove this closed bracket, and the value is k minus 1. And again, I request you mind it that we have not substituted value of h. Without substituting value of h, by assuming only, the outcome has come k minus 1. Now kk can be cancelled, and this minus limit h tends to 0 minus h plus 1 will tend to 1. Will tend to 1. It is the limiting value of this function. And since RHL is not equal to what? LHL. Since RHL is not equal to LHL, and we have taken k as an arbitrary integer, so k could be any value, 1, 2, 0, minus 1, plus 2, plus 3, anything. But in general, k is what? So k is an integer, and now we need to remove this k is equal to 5. RHL is not equal to LHL, therefore the function is discontinuous at all integers.